Once you've assembled the gable walls, the laminated beams can be installed. The installation procedure is shown on the beam plan, but here are a few quick pointers. It's always better to start with the outer or lower beams and then finish with the ridge beam. For beams fixed with alumini brackets, have a look at page 29 in the Fraemohs Builder's Manual. If you have a beam pocket, then installing the beam is as simple as lifting the beam up and dropping the beam into the pocket from above. Where the beam penetrates through a beam pocket, it reduces in size. This has two benefits. Firstly, it acts as a weather seal if the beam is to penetrate through an external wall, and secondly, it locks the beam in place and prevents the beam from moving. If an alumini bracket has been specified, then you'll need to first measure the position of the bracket and mark this on the wall. The alumini bracket is fixed to the wall with anchor nails by hammering the nails through the pre-drilled holes in the bracket. The size of the alumini brackets and the number of anchor nails required is determined by the engineer. Please refer to their plans for this detail. Once the alumini bracket is fixed to the wall, it's time to lift the beam into position. If you've got a bracket connection at each end of the beam, you can lift the beam into position from below. If this beam has a beam pocket at one end and a bracket at the other, you'll need to lower the beam down from above. Once you've lifted the beam into position, it'll require propping while you fix the bracket to the beam. We suggest you pre-cut a prop support at the right height prior to lifting the beam in place and have this ready. With the beam safely propped in place, it's important to check the beam is level prior to fixing the beam to the bracket. You may also need to use a sash clamp to gently pull the gable wall into position. Once you're happy that the beam is level and at the right height, you can screw in the self-drilling dowels. The number of these dowels is specified in the engineer's plans. Once we have all the beams in and the bones of our home in place, we can move on to the fascia.